In today's video, we are gonna be making a simple abstract design in Blender. So let's jump into the video. Remove the default cube. Add a circle mesh into the viewport. Duplicate the circle and hide one of them. Select the circle and subdivide it. As you can clearly see that the total number of vertices are 64 at the moment. Hide the first circle and unhide the second one. Then perform a subdivision to the circle with a number of cuts to 3 and smoothness to 1. Press F to fill the circle in edit mode. Then add a solidify modifier to it. Increase the thickness to 0.1 meter. Then add a bevel modifier to it and enter the amount to 0.01 and segments to 5. After that, apply shade smooth. Now select the circle and move it far away from the main view. Enable the first circle and press Ctrl, Alt and 0 to align the camera to the scene. Select the circle and rotate it 90 degrees in x-axis. The number of vertices and edges on the circle are 64. Add a particle system to the circle and select here. Enter number of emissions to 64. In source, select emit from vertices. For the number of emissions, you can go with any other value you want, but a multiple of 10 like 60 is just a perfect value for the number of emissions. Uncheck random order. Select render as object and the second circle as the instance object. This is perfect to showcase that a value which is a multiple of 10 like 60 is perfect for the number of emissions. Increase the scale randomness value to something around 0.6. Select the camera and adjust its focal length value, and in transform settings adjust its y-axis location value to get a proper camera alignment. Go to particle setting and enable object rotation. Select the second circle and rotate it 45 degrees in x-axis. Add a simple deform modifier to the circle and select stretch. Add a plane mesh to the viewport and use it as a background for the scene. Head over to the rendered mode and delete the default light source. Then after that, add a gradient texture to the background surface. Select the background plane and use the same shading technique as shown in the video. You can go with any other different color of your choice, but for the tutorial purpose, I am going for a black background. Select the second circle and increase metallic and specular to 1 and decrease roughness to 0.3. Add a color ramp node and join it to base color. Add a colored stop to the color ramp and change it to a shade of blue. Switch from linear to constant. And after that, distribute the colored stops from left. Add a gradient texture and join it to the color ramp. Then add a particle info node and join random to vector. Switch from object to world and add a color ramp between gradient texture and background node. Increase the strength of the background a little bit. Add multiple color stops to the color ramp and enter color values as shown in the video. You can also go with a different color and different setup for the scene as per your choice. Press Ctrl plus T to get the texture coordinate plus mapping node. In the mapping node, rotate the X, Y and Z axis to get a control over the whole lighting in the scene. As you can clearly see that without any light source, you can get some cool looking interesting light from using textures. And that's all for today's video. Hope you all learned something new. We'll see you in the next video. Till then, stay tuned and keep learning.